You know, I go on and on about the importance of wearing sunscreen all year round, but I get that when summer is here, that topic gets more and more attention. So I asked you guys if you had any questions you wanted to answer, and yes, yes you had. So let's get to the first one. What's the difference between mineral, chemical and physical sunscreen, and is one better than the other? Hi, I'm Dr. Anne. I'm a medical doctor with a passion for skincare that works. On this channel, we explore the science behind skin and do quick reviews so you learn to pick exactly those products that work for your individual skin concern. So if this is something you're interested in, please consider subscribing and ring the notification bell. Sadly, the different kinds of sunscreen divide the online community up to a point where battles are fought about which kind is the right kind. So let me preface this video with this important statement. I don't care which sunscreen you wear, as long as it's broad spectrum and you wear it every day. With that being said, let's look at the different names. Back when I was young, centuries ago, we only had two categories, physical and chemical. Well, when I was really young, we only had one bottle and that smelled of coconuts and had an SPF of 4, I think, and I have no clue if it had any filters at all. But back to topic. At first, there were physical and chemical filters. Somewhere along the way, some very clever people mentioned correctly that everything is a chemical, so the filters should be rightly called organic and inorganic instead. And then, of course, marketing stepped in and renamed the physical ones to mineral ones, or even called them natural sunscreens, which apparently sells better. To complete the confusion, these days some brands sell natural sunscreen and refer to antioxidants, which are great, but of course no sunscreen. Don't despair though, it is actually pretty easy. So let's go through it one by one. First, physical sunscreens. Physical sunscreens are also called inorganic or mineral sunscreens because their two filters are zinc oxide and titanium dioxide, based on minerals. Calling them natural is of course misleading, as they need to undergo a purification process before suitable for use in skincare products, so they are as processed as any other filter you will find. The downsides of physical sunscreens are the fact that they tend to leave a white cast and are often less cosmetically elegant, meaning they are denser and harder to distribute. An advantage is that they usually cause less irritation than some of the preferably older chemical filters out there, which is especially true if you rely on US sunscreens. You might have heard that physical sunscreens reflect light rather than absorb it, which is what chemical sunscreens do, but that is not entirely true. Physical sunscreens reflect around 5% of the incoming UV rays and absorb the rest, so there's basically no difference in how they work on your skin because these 5% don't really matter. It is important to note that only zinc oxide will provide enough protection from UVA rays to qualify as broad spectrum sunscreen, and that blue light, which has become kind of a hot topic, I will link a video that I did on that issue up here, has a chance to be absorbed by mineral sunscreens. Second, chemical sunscreens. There's a broad variety of substances that fall under this category, and not all of them are available in every part of the world, which is why I'm not going to list all of them, but focus on the most important ones. The main part that sets them apart is the spectrum in which they absorb the UV rays. Most are effective either in the UVA or in the UVB range, with only a few newer ones absorbing both equally good. UVB you have homozolate, octocrylene, octinoxate, octisalate, oxybenzone, all of which are approved for use in the US. And then tinosorb A2B, tinosorb S, tinosorb M, all of which are broad spectrum, so they absorb both UVA and UVB. And Uvinul T150. These are the ones that you will find most often used in current formulations. UVA, avobenzone, which is, with the exception of Mexoryl SX, a patented filter, the only chemical filter for UVA protection that is available in US sunscreens. It is, however, rather unstable and often irritating and partly responsible for the bad rep chemical sunscreens get from those with sensitive skin. Modern UVA filters to look out for are Tinosorb M, Tinosorb S, Tinosorb A2B, Uvinul A+. The downside is that especially the older ones can be irritating and are unstable when used alone. Their advantage is that they are usually much easier to spread and more comfortable to wear without that thick sunscreen feeling. A quick word on them being hormonal disruptors and being absorbed into the body. There is no data showing that this is of any concern for human beings, as the amount you would need to have a hormonal effect is equivalent to continuous use for several hundred years. And for the coral reef debate, I will link to a video Lab Muffin Beauty Science made on this topic in the description box and just say I agree. Now to the last point. Antioxidants. UV radiation is one of the main sources of free radicals, which in turn lead to oxidative damage to the cells and skin aging. Antioxidants help catch the free radicals, preventing this damage. On top of that, sunscreen filters themselves can produce free radicals when they degrade. This risk is higher the more unstable the filter is, read higher with old chemical filters. But knowing that, it makes perfect sense to add antioxidants to sunscreens in order to enhance its positive effect. It does, however, not make any sense at all to use antioxidants instead of sunscreen, claiming they will undo the damage done by the UV rays, which is why you don't need any filters. It just doesn't work that way. Wear a proper broad-spectrum sunscreen, and if that contains antioxidants, even better. If not, consider using an antioxidant serum in your skincare. But never, ever use antioxidants instead of sunscreen. And never, ever use sunscreen drops to mix into your day cream, but that's a topic for a different video. Until then, ask any questions that remain unanswered. Maybe click on one of the videos that I've got the link on the screen. And I'm going to see you all very soon with another video. Bye!